Hello and welcome back to the second episode of the video series focusing on Amazon Comprehend, a fully managed and continuously trained natural language processing service that uses machine learning to uncover valuable insights and connections in text. I'm Swagat Kulkarni, Senior Solutions Architect in AWS, and today I'll be talking about Amazon Comprehend pre-trained models and APIs. It all starts with your data. The data can consist of a variety of documents or text, such as social interactions, logs, emails, phone conversations, and many more. Next, you input the data to Amazon Comprehend and use pre-trained models to extract insights from the data. These models are exposed by way of easy-to-consume APIs. There are multiple ways of interacting with these APIs, starting with AWS command line interface or CLI, programmatically by using SDKs in multiple programming languages such as Java and Python or AWS console. Let's take a look at these APIs in action from the AWS console first, followed by programmatic access using Python. After you log into AWS console, type Comprehend in the search bar and then click on the result that shows Amazon Comprehend. Next, click on Launch Amazon Comprehend. This takes you to a page where you can perform real-time analysis on the input text. As you can see, there are two analysis types, built-in and custom. And today we'll focus on the built-in analysis type which leverages the pre-trained models. You would notice that a sample text is already available for analysis. Let's click the Analyze button now. Once the analysis is completed, Amazon Comprehend presents the insights gained from the input text. Let's start with the Entities tab first. An entity is textual reference to the unique name of a real-world object such as people, places, and commercial items. Comprehend can recognize up to 9 different entities in the input documents. Here you can see Amazon Comprehend API call returned the pre-trained entities and its type from the text along with the confidence score. The confidence score is a number between 0 and 1. Low confidence score means that the service's confidence in its output is low. Conversely, if the service is highly confident of its output, the score will be closer to 1. Next, we look at Key Phrases tab. A key phrase is a string containing a noun phrase and the modifier such as adjectives that describes a particular thing. Here you can see the list of noun phrases and its modifier that Amazon Comprehend detected and the associated confidence level. The next tab is language. This tab shows the dominant language of the text and Amazon Comprehend's level of confidence that it has detected the dominant language correctly. In this case, it correctly identified English as the dominant language with a high confidence score of 0.99. Amazon Comprehend can now recognize 100 different languages. The PII tab lists entities in your input text that contain personally identifiable information or PII. A PII entity is a textual reference to personal data that could be used to identify an individual. Examples include an address, bank account number, or phone number. There are two different modes here. The offset analysis mode identifies the location of PII in your text documents. The Labels Analysis mode checks for the presence of PII in your text document and returns the labels of identified PII entity types. As you can see, in the Offset mode, Amazon Comprehend returned the actual values of the PII entity types, such as name, credit card number, bank account number, etc. When we toggle to the Labels mode, the API returned just the entity types, such as name, email, bank account number, and corresponding confidence score. The Sentiment tab shows the dominant sentiment of the text. Sentiment can be rated as neutral, positive, negative, or mixed. In this scenario, you can see Amazon Comprehend detected the sentiment as neutral with a high confidence score of 0.98. And finally, the Syntax tab shows a breakdown of each element in the text along with its part of speech, such as proper noun, verb, pronoun, etc., and the associated confidence score. You can use the results of this syntactic analysis to gain a richer understanding of the content of your documents. Next, let's explore ways to programmatically access the pre-trained APIs using the Python SDK. Here, we are showing a Jupyter notebook which provides step-by-step instructions to use Amazon Comprehend APIs to uncover information in unstructured data. We will explore 6 pre-trained APIs: identifying named entities, extracting key phrases, identifying the dominant language, determining emotional sentiment, determining syntax, and detecting personally identifiable information or PII. Let's look at the cells in this notebook one by one and their outputs. We start by importing Boto3. Porto3 is the name of the Python SDK for AWS. Porto3 makes it easy to integrate your Python applications, library, or script with AWS services. We will use this SDK to work with Amazon Comprehend pre-trained APIs in this notebook. Next, we specify the region where this notebook instance is running in. Import other packages such as JSON, Pandas, and NumPy, and then use Porto3 SDK to create a Comprehend client object. Next, we look at the input text. Here, you will see the same sample text that was used in the Amazon Comprehend console. First up, we'll start with identifying named entities. Named entities can be real-world objects denoted with a proper name. In this cell, we have invoked DetectEntities API by passing the sample text and the language code of the text, in this case, English. The response is a JSON output containing entities array. Each object in the array has the location of the entity in the text identified by the begin and end offset value, the confidence score of the model, the actual text, and the type of entity such as person, organization, quantity, etc. The output of the next cell shows the same output in a more human-readable format, as shown here. Next, we use the same text to detect key phrases. Here, we have invoked Detect Key Phrase API by passing the sample text and the language code. The API response is an array of key phrases, and each object contains the begin and end offsets, the confidence scores, and the actual key phrase. Let's keep cruising, and next up is language detection. Here, we have invoked Detect Dominant Language API and passed the sample text. If more than one language is detected, the API returns detected language and its corresponding score. The response is an array of languages, as shown here. The API has correctly identified English as the dominant language with a high confidence score of 99%. Again, we show the same output in a human-readable format. Next is sentiment analysis, and the API used is called Detect Sentiment. As you can see by now, the API input follows the familiar pattern of passing the sample text along with the language code. The response returns the sentiment value, in this case the value is neutral, along with the sentiment score, which is similar to the confidence score and has values ranging between 0 and 1, assigned to each sentiment. You can see the neutral sentiment has the highest score here of approximately 0.98. Here is the reformatted output showing the sentiment value and the corresponding sentiment score. Next is syntax detection, which is used to identify the part of speech for each word in the text. Here, we have invoked Detect Syntax API. The API response returns an array of syntax tokens, with each member element of the array consisting of offsets, part of speech score, and tag to denote the values such as interjection, proper noun, verb, etc., along with the text and the token ID. Again, you can see the readable version of the same output with the text, part of speech, and corresponding score. Finally, we look at personally identifiable information detection. Here, we have invoked Detect PII Entities API to detect the PII information in the input text, such as name, address, bank account number. Following the familiar pattern, the API response returns the offset of the PII value, the confidence score, and the corresponding PII type. Here is the same output in a readable format. We can also use Contains PII Entities API to label documents that contain PII. As you can see in the output, the API response returned 5 labels identified from the text and the confidence score for each one of them. And here is the reformatted version of the same output. This brings us to the end of this notebook. In this notebook, we learned how to use Amazon Comprehend pre-trained APIs for various scenarios and invoke them using AWS Python SDK. Thank you very much for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed learning about Amazon Comprehend pre-trained models and APIs. Go ahead and check out the resources shown here to explore further. Please keep an eye for upcoming videos on Amazon Comprehend and how you can use it to solve business problems.